Kazuwe Bashir Mbazira, Member of Parliament representing the people of Koempe South. As you can see, I'm a proud member of the National Unity Platform. I'm also the self-appointed minister in charge of information, communication, and national guidance.
Clearly says that there shall be a leader of opposition in the parliament. In absence of the leader of opposition, Dr. Abed Bwanika is able, willing, and ready. I'm a member of parliament from Chimanya Kabonera Masaka City.
The first regional parliamentary sitting kicked off today in Gulu City. Speaker Anita Moore, who is chairing the meeting, said the decision to hold parliamentary sittings in Uganda's four traditional regions is aimed at bridging the gap between parliament and the people. She criticized legislators who boycotted the sitting, said they deprived the electorate of the opportunities that come with the regional sitting. Citing Article 95, Section 2 of the Constitution and Rule 17 of the Parliament's Rules of Procedure, Among confirmed that the regional sittings are legally and procedurally sound.
Same legal basis upon which Parliament sits in Kololo under the ceremonial grounds and Kampala Serena Hotel. In any case, Gulu, where we are holding the historic sitting, is part of Uganda. And therefore, no one in their own right mind or state of mind can attempt to deprive the beloved people of Northern Uganda the opportunity of the landmark city.
During the session, the speaker also led the MPs in observing moments of silence for the lives lost and property destroyed at the Chitezi garbage landfill in Wakiso district, as well as in memory of the late Professor Edward Kidu Makubuya, a former MP and minister who passed away recently. President Yoweri Museveni is expected to address Parliament tomorrow. Police in Chenjojo district have confirmed a deadly accident which involved 15 members of the same family that took place in Kayura in Fort Fortro Kampala Road and left 10 people dead. The Rwenzori West Region's police spokesperson Vincent Wesige revealed that the fatal road accident involved Isuzu registration number UBE8070 belonging to Poco Poco Bus Company, which was coming from Kampala. It collided with the Toyota Hiace taxi registration number UBR812G, which was coming from Fort Fortro. The bodies of the deceased and the injured were taken to Chenjojo Hospital for post-mortem and medical attention accordingly. The two vehicles were towed to Chenjojo Central Police Station while the driver of the bus is on the run. Michael Kananura, the spokesperson for the Directorate of Traffic and Road Safety at Uganda Police Force, attributed the accident to reckless driving by the taxi driver.
10 people dying at once, moreover in one vehicle. It's not a small number. And how this crash occurred, just because this person, the driver, was driving all day on his normal route is the Kabale Mbarara. Don't stress yourself to drive, just rest and then drive the other day.
The murder trial of businessman Henry Katanga continued today before High Court Judge Justice Isaac Muwata with the testimony of the eighth witness, Andrew Kizimula Mubiru. He is the acting director of forensic services for the police. He detailed the findings in the 19 exhibits that were collected in connection with the murder. Obiru said forensics links three individuals, Henry Katanga, widow Molly Katanga, and their daughter Patricia Kankwanza, to the murder. However, some exhibits such as the pistol and the bullet shell were not presented before the court because they are still undergoing investigations.
The DNA profile from this specimen is a single source female profile. His DNA profile is a billion times more likely. If the suspect Kakwanza Patricia is the donor, the suspect Monica Tanga and one untested individual from the Ugandan population are donor contributors.
The defense bench led by Erijon Karuhanga rejected the consideration of the police form as part of the exhibits, saying that Mubiru was not the one who made this report. They also demanded all exhibits be tabled before the court, including the police officers who investigated the case. Muwata adjourned the hearing till tomorrow when the court will determine if the exhibits will be considered as evidence.